In 1976, when I was a senior in high school, my parents, my father bought a two-unit right at 2133 South Millard next to my grandmother's. So that was my introduction to North Lyndale, really, as far as being a resident. That same year, I graduated from high school and went up to Northern Illinois as a college freshman, but I spent all my time back in my old neighborhood by California and Jackson and East Garfield, because that's where my homies were, that's where my comfort level was. I did not become a real North Lyndalian until I moved my business in North Lyndale in 1996. And I want to pause and just give reflection to Robert Steele, because Robert was the he was the executive director of Lyndale Business and Local Development Corporation, and he had the idea of having an incubator over at 3333 West Arlington. And that was the start of my first office. It was about 100 square feet. Actually, my mother had retired. She used to work at Sears. Sears moved downtown and then into Hoffman Estates, and she retired. So I brought her out of retirement to do some volunteer work for me as I got my agency started. Then I moved from there over to, I spent 4 years there, then was able to purchase a building on Roosevelt Road, and I had my office there. And my my whole goal, when I started with American Family and they send you to school for training and you have to come up with a business plan. And I'm a social worker by trade. You know, I went to school and I worked in social work for about 5, 6, 7 years. So my heart has always been in the community and giving back and helping, and hopefully you can reap some of the rewards as you help somebody as opposed to just trying to sell somebody. And during that time, it was a young lady when I was on Arlington that lived across the park on Polk that, her mother was one of my clients, and she was like, hey, you need somebody to work for you? I was expanding some. She said, yeah. So her daughter, who had just had a baby, probably 6 months old, named Tina, she started working for me, and she worked for me for actually 15 years. She went back. She had to drop out of college because she got pregnant. She went back, got her AA. Then she went to DePaul, got her BA, and then now she's actually working on getting her doctorate in medicine as a 40-something-year-old single mom. And those are the type of things that, you know, you kind of hear about, you kind of think about, but you don't give too much thought as to how you may have helped someone and someone as they were helping you. I'm not going to be too long because I can get windy. And actually, I'm getting a little nostalgic because as I sit out again and look over that way, you know, what brought me back to North Lyndale as a resident? Because I got married in 84, and in 88, me and a wife moved to Bellwood, lived out there for 15 years. But all the time, my kids went to school, actually wound up being in North Lyndale. They went to Blessed Sacrament for grammar school, and then wound up going to Providence St. Mel for high school. So I've been a Westsider all my life, and I would die being a Westsider. One thing about here in North Lyndale and being a Westsider, it's just something in the air, it's something in the water, it's something in the hot dogs, and now there's something in the vegetables that's growing up down in the street. I mean, it's called, I think it's flavor, it's called True Grit. You know, when I've spoken to grammar schoolers and high schoolers, and they're from the West Side, I say, hey man, you all have it made, because you, to me, you have an edge. If you can go to school here, if you can live here, you have an edge when it comes to competing in college, competing in your professional life, because it's just some type of pride that's, it's just in the air. And it's here, it's in Austin, it's in East Garfield. They tore the projects down, but the projects are still in us, even if we didn't live there, because we had to deal with people from there. So, and I look out and I see Miss Redman and then Bobby Wright, who were have been clients of mine for years, and it's just something, you know, that's what makes me proud. When I can sell and service someone in the community that I live in, it's no better feeling. When I was on Roosevelt Road and just being able to interact with the drug dealers, interact with the little kids that's going to school, interact with the other merchants, you know, that's, to me, it's like going back to when you had all the businesses on the street. You know, I was able to witness, I lived in East Garfield when the riots came, so Madison Street was close to me, so I could witness Madison Street burning down. I knew when we came back trying to go over my grandmother's, the stores, you know, even the car dealerships, their windows were bursting out. So to me, you know, community, as Paul mentioned, as far as me working with NHS on the neighborhood level and then downtown on the board, I've been on different boards here in North Lawndale. And I got to tell you, I'm going to be honest, be transparent. I got burnt out in North Lawndale. I got burnt out. I got went through a time just feeling, okay, you put in time, you put in effort, but what are you getting out of it? You know, are you growing financially? Is your business growing? And I became a little disenchanted. And not only in the lack of reciprocity, as I felt, but then just in disenchanted in life as it was going. When we hit that that down in, what, 2005, that 2007, when the market and everything fell, that's when a lot of dreams got affected. I saw people losing houses. I saw people losing cars. Oh, Mr. Lenz, we got it. I don't have that car no more. Mr. Lenz, I don't have that house no more. We gotta cancel the policy. I don't have anything to insure. You know, where's my, you know, dreams left? On businesses, on homes, individuals. But, you know, God is still a good God, and we saw it start coming back and coming back. And actually, I moved from Roosevelt to Cermak to outside of North Lawndale, because during that time, I was like, hey, maybe I just need a new scenery, get that fresh breath of air. But then back in December, I moved back to North Lawndale. I'm over in the Nichols Towers. And it's like being back home, you know, the old prodigal son, even though, you know, not that deep, because I really hadn't lived, because I live in the 1800 block of Troy. So, but just to close it out, Paul paid me a compliment, but I want to pay Paul a compliment on two fronts. One front was years ago, Paul had an idea about having the Obama Library right here in North Lawndale. I was one of the first people he talked to, me and Charles Leakes. Charles Leakes, he listened to him. I'm like, Paul, you got to go on. I can't think that big. You know, I can't think that big. But Paul, he persisted, and we almost got it. And then a few years ago, he started talking about this word that I can't pronounce, but it's on my button, 150 years. And he just encourages me and other individuals of, hey, we have a lot to be proud of. No matter, you know, if it's things are good, like the building we're in, or you got vacant lots down there. But we have a lot of proud history. Sears Robot was here. Uncle worked there. I said my mother worked there. I just started looking at little things that led to big things. And with that, you know, I'm just proud to be here. Modro. His father, though, is one that was on 16th Street for years, decades, and would go in as a businessman, and he like had that cigar dangling out of his mouth, telling the war stories. But the thing about it, his war stories became my war stories. I started living them. The war stories from Dave's. She told about her father, and before she was even born. So everything is cyclical. And with that, you know, we have to keep in mind those that are watching us. You know, I did not realize how many people watch me because I was just doing what I had to do. But we watch each other. So we have to be cognizant of the fact that we are examples to our young men, women. You selling hot dogs, but you the hot dog lady, and they proud of it. Ed is selling drugs, but he's not selling, he's not slinging drugs. He's selling drugs. That's my pharmacist, you know, and I would love for us to get back to the time I used to speak. I'd say, hey, I got my accountant was black, my dentist was black, my doctor was black, my wife was black, my children were black. You know, everybody that I did business with is black. And it was an intentional effort. I had to seek them out. Yeah, I told my wife, hey, forget Walgreens. You know, I'm going on Ridgeway and 16. You know, that's where I'm going to get my drugs from. And Ed, you got some good drugs over there too. Now. But with that, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you.